Let us pray. O God, who calls creation into being with the Word, yet is as close to us as our own breath, may we feel your closeness and the warmth of your embrace in this time of sharing together in this place, we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. The prophet Isaiah writes, "Comfort, comfort my people, says your God." At a Bible study some years ago, one of the saints of our congregation, Helen Groneweg, shared that when she thought about God, she thought of a comforter, a big, warm blanket wrapped around her and all of God's people. So just think about Helen's wonderful image of the Holy. Feel it. Sink into that lovely image for a moment. God is a comforter wrapped around you, enfolding you with warmth and care. Since 2007, our congregation has had a prayer shawl ministry. Shawls are creatively, prayerfully knit, and then they're blessed, and they're given to those who might appreciate a tangible symbol of the love of God for them, so they can wrap themselves in the shawl and feel the care of our congregation. They can enclose themselves in the love of God. And when we bless prayer shawls, one of the prayers we use includes these words: may those enfolded in these shawls feel God's loving embrace. May those warmed by these shawls know the warmth of God's care. God enfolds us in love. God is our comforter. Comfort, comfort my people, says our God. Isaiah's comforting words were written in a time when God's people were distressed. Soon their land would feel the wrath of a foreign invader. The prophet predicted that they would be sent into exile. The people would soon be forcibly taken into faraway Babylon. And even in this time of growing shadow, the prophet of God encouraged people by talking of God's abiding comfort. God will always be near, ready to offer care, ready to enfold God's people in the grace of God. Comfort, comfort, says God to God's people. In the Hebrew of Isaiah, the word we translate as comfort carries a wealth of meaning: comfort, consolation. In Hebrew, the word comfort is rooted in a word that suggests a deep sigh or a deep breath. So enfolded in the comfort of God, we can breathe and feel relief. The English word comfort has interesting origins too. Come, fort. So the second syllable, fort, comes from the Latin fortis or forte, which means strong, powerful, brave. The prefix com, like in community, it means with or together. So the English word comfort means strong together. Comfort, comfort my people in times of distress or hardship. We are stronger together. But there are challenges before us in our world that require our collective strength. Of that, there can be no doubt. Climate change, the drumbeat of war, anti-Semitism, Islamophobia, transphobia, poverty, poverty and income equality. We know that there are challenges to pulling together to face the things that are before us. Disinformation, polarization, the information silos of social media which give us different realities in which we live, political leaders who use fear and loathing to gain and keep power. That we are stronger together than we are fragmented or alone, that's something we know too. Think of the pandemic, that challenging not that long ago time. In a global review of how nations fared in their response to COVID, we Canadians did very well relative to other places in the world. Our governments, federal, provincial, and local, got middling grades for their response to this public health emergency. And particularly, they noted that the poorer members of our society suffered a lot under COVID. But the Canadian population, we got very high grades for the way in which we pulled together, for the way in which most Canadians demonstrated concern for the most vulnerable among us. It was our collective response to this emergency and our concern and care for our neighbors that created a strong national pandemic response. Or think of how we as a congregation are able to do more together than we could do alone. Together, we work to help 175 households in our community through Christmas cheer. Collectively, we put together 147 gift boxes for the children and young people in the catchment area of the Banff Community House. Pooling resources, we welcome 4 new refugees in the coming weeks, reuniting a family long separated by war. We use the word comfort often in funeral liturgies when we celebrate a life together as a community of faith. When we endure loss or hardship, there is comfort. There is strength in being together. There's comfort gained from being in a faith community. We are stronger when we are not alone. In his book, The Better Angels of Our Nature, Harvard psychologist Steven Pinker argues that humanity becomes less violent, more compassionate, and humane when people of other races, languages, ethnicities, cultures, religions, sexual orientations, genders are seen as being fully human, equal before the law, equally deserving of dignity and security. When the borders between us, the lines we draw between people are erased and we see ourselves as being together, there is strength, and we treat each other more kindly, more gently. When we are connected, good things result. Comfort, comfort, says our God. And the ultimate comfort comes from the ultimate comforter, a word in the Hebrew tradition that is sometimes used for God. And then Jesus said that another comforter would come after him. He was a comforter, and the Holy Spirit to come would comfort even more and on into the future. Isaiah spoke words to people living in a time of distress and peril to remind them that God would always be near, offering comfort. And in Advent, we wait for God to draw near in Jesus. In Advent, we express a longing for God to come close, to draw us together, to enfold us in love. Comfort, comfort my people, says your God. May it be so. Amen.